and show you how Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express tried to break Brian Pillman's neck.
You know, I want to share something with you idiots. It's the funniest laugh I've had in a week or two. They're saying that Flying Brian has gone out and asked for a match against beautiful Bobby Eaton. Now, I know what you're saying. How could he be that stupid when just a couple of weeks ago he had the worst beating he's ever suffered in his whole stinking life against the Midnight Express? Well, that's what they're saying, but the match has been signed. Z-Man, you say, where is he? Why ain't it a tag team match? Because Z-Man, a thought entered his head, and before it died of loneliness, he realized that he didn't want to be anywhere around, because he's a yellow stinking coward with a yellow streak down his back as long as the interstate and just as wide. So let me tell you something, Flying Brian. When you get in that ring with beautiful Bobby Eaton, he has been wrestling since you were this tall, and that's how tall you're going to be when he gets finished with you. You talk about flying off the top rope, he spent more time in the air than a Delta pilot, and he's going to teach you a thing or two before he slaps you around, shakes you for change, and beats you. And just to make sure the referee don't cheat us, I'm going to be at ringside, and so is Sweet Stan, because the Midnight Express are sick of being ripped off.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is set for one fall. It is your TV main event. It is a special challenge captain's match. Introducing team number one.
Hey, what's Dan Lane doing out there? This is Bobby Eaton against Flying Brian.
And Tuesday in Canton, Ohio. Then Wednesday we're going to be in Myrtle Beach in Harrisburg.
going on in the ring. And of course, a reminder, we are just hours away from the Keel in St. Louis. A superb card. We hope to see you fans there.
I'll tell you what, I want to see my old buddy Sam Mushnick up there.
I'll be there for the 900 line with Lance Russell at the beautiful Keel Auditorium in St. Louis.
Terrific elbow there by Bobby Eaton. Pillman's on the floor right at this particular time. There's Bobby with him. What's he going to do? He's in a vertical suplex. He's on the floor. Beautiful maneuver. Oh, my gosh. Drove him right into that post.
That might say ruse on the post. But when you're smacked into it, you say ouch and a lot more. A chop there from Pillman.
Conniption.
I have no idea. It's just something we say in Maine.
It's got to be something horribly obnoxious if Cornette has one.
You come up with all your Texas sayings, and I just figure it's something you say in Texas. In Maine, we say conniption fit.
There's that rancid-looking individual again. Tries to steal my grill. I'll teach him one of these days.
Standing side headlock now by Eaton. Pillman looking for a way to work out of it. That's a quick two count. Eaton got Pillman over with the help of a pull of the hair. So good to see the referee using his authority to make sure Stan Lane not able to interfere on this match and made sure that he went back to the locker room. This is our main event, this week's edition of Worldwide Wrestling. I can't wait to tell the fans what our main event is next week. Two of the biggest men this sport has ever seen.
I'll tell you what, we're going to have Teddy Long out here to tell us about it, too, in a little bit. About the Road Warrior Hawk going up against Butch Reed of Doom.
You just ruined it.
Next week. So, as I'm telling them about it.
Why do I never get to say that kind of stuff?
Drop down, leapfrog, another leapfrog. Catches even a power slam. Back up the drop kick.
A superb wrestler, but the young Brian Pillman, give him his due. All right, looks like Eaton is now back in the ring.
You want to make that mountain?
Do I what?
You said give him his due. I said you want to make that mountain. You know, mountain.
I hope they're a sponsor. I really do. We're being sponsored this week by Castrol Motor Oil. Do you use that?
I drink it once in a while.
No, that's castor oil.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Good night. Why Brian Pillman really needs to protect his neck.
That's what the Midnight Express and Jim Cornette did, Terry Funk.
Yeah, they're going to it right now. But the dog has a weak point. You get out there and do it in. That Cornette, he's got his nerves, doesn't he?
Yeah, that's true. Now Eaton is outside along with Pillman. Oh, don't drop, no. He's going to try to get back in. Now, Eaton's going to help him in. Now,
back to that neck again, boy. They're going back to that neck again and again, Chris. They're not trying to win this match. This guy's trying to put him out of wrestling. Cornette's trying to put him out of wrestling. This has something to do with trying to
get a win.
They are trying to put this boy out of professional wrestling. And they might do it.
This match may have to be stopped. This is too much. This is.
It's a captain's match right here. Trying to come back at him. I'll tell you what. Ryan Pillman is trying his best to make a comeback at this time.
Another neck breaker. Now he should go for the pin. He does. But he doesn't hook the leg. Let's see if Pillman does punch. He kicks out. About 2.5 there. Eaton with a kick. He whips himself into the ropes. But Pillman follows up with a neck breaker of his own. And now both men flat on his mat.
They're both down. They're both down. Both getting back up to their feet.
Oh, my God.
Desperation chops right there. Shoots him off. Gets him in the backdrop.
Eaton is high flying. He didn't want to fly that high for that reason, however. Now Pillman tries to follow up, but Eaton was waiting for him. He whips him outside again. But Pillman up quickly. He knocks our cameraman down. He doesn't care. A fight. Oh. Misses.
Telegraph that move, and Eaton moved out of the way.
Should be it. He hooks the leg.
No.
Pillman kicks out. Eaton has got to be thinking at this point, Terry, what more do I have to do to defeat him? Cornette is up on the apron. He tells Eaton to go